This is Wayne Myers at the Law Enforcement Center after the interagency meeting with the PIO for the City of Jamestown, Stutsman County, and other agencies, Fritz Fremgem. And it was a busy meeting today, Fritz, and a lot was covered. And if you could possibly summarize some of the more important things that were going on today.
We talked about that township officers meeting being set up a day or so ago, and it's firmed up. We do have a time and place for it, 7 p.m. in the Exchequer Room at the Civic Center. You know, there's a lot of townships and a lot of township officers, so we moved it to the Exchequer Room to ensure we had enough space. Tito Hernandez of FEMA was here today and indicated, I will get you a FEMA person at that meeting so that the questions, we do the best with answering the questions that we can. With no presidential declaration yet approved, he said it's still in Washington. It's hard for him to answer for sure what's going to be covered, but they can give us an idea of the process, and maybe they can give us an idea of some of the time lags. And then the idea is to figure out what we can do towards fixing these township and county roads now. I'll be there as well to discuss joint powers agreements. 7 o'clock, Exchequer Room, Monday, 7 p.m. Township officers, FEMA, and county officials. Let's talk about the system and the water. As you know, the Corps was at a peak on how much water it was putting down the James River yesterday. I remember at our meeting it was at 2,000, and they were hoping to have 2,200 coming down the James. What we saw were some soil issues where the soil got so much water in it that the water was just looking for any place to go that it could find. And down there in past the post office, west of the post office, that part of town, southwest part of town, got some issues in its sanitary sewer system. And the engineers were down there pumping it out of the sewers and into tanker trucks and moving it on out to the sewage lagoons. What they found was the system was getting inundated. There's always little cracks and so on in people's pipes, and if the pressure is greater outside the pipe than inside, it finds the crack and it goes inside. And before you know it, the system is filled and the lift station can't keep up. Reed said that that lift station down there ran 23.8 hours out of 24, that the alarms were going off. They got down there and started to investigate what they had and responded quickly. Now they're still going to work some more investigation to figure out where does this start and where does it stop, and then they hope to bring in another pump. This is today's plan, bring in another pump and move some of that effluent to a different part of the system and use a different lift station to take it all the way to where it belongs, to waste treatment. And he thought that that's more of a permanent solution than cordoning off or sectionalizing that little piece of the system. He did indicate that they found somebody who was discharging a sump pump into the sanitary sewer 24/7 in that area. So there it happened. You know, the press has asked probably every day for the last week, please don't pump down into that sanitary system. It puts extra strain. So we really ask for help if you can't do it, but let's get these sump pumps out into the yard rather than down the drain, or we're all going to be ankle deep in stuff we don't want to be ankle deep in. We did have an issue. You know what? I was expecting dike issues, seepage, and so on. And we did have 5 calls that were responded to and evaluated. But what we found was that groundwater issue, and then kind of a stacking issue where the water just couldn't get through the channel fast enough. And we had it stacking up around the Nicias Park area. And we needed to put some bags down real quick. So what the Corps seems to be thinking today is, rather than building higher and wider dikes, probably they're just going to let less water out of the James. And that's back to the risk. You'd like that pool as low as you can, as fast as you can, in case we get a lot of rain. Mike Zimmerman is working. Just in case you haven't seen his truck, he is out there. He's got things as big as the bottom of a bridge is washed out, and he can't even find the bottom of it anymore. So again, bringing in fill to try and support that. They are fixing gravel roads. And again, we're going to have that meeting 7 p.m. on Monday with a FEMA rep and township and county officials. So unless you have questions, that's the update for the 23rd of April.
All right, thank you, Fritz. Fritz Fremgem, the PIO for Stutsman County, City of Jamestown, and other entities. And this is Wayne Byers reporting from the Law Enforcement Center in Jamestown.
$24.99 per month for high-speed internet? What a deal! That's right, CSI Cable's high-speed, low-price internet for just $24.99 per month. Here's the deal. CSI Cable users can get $5 off per month for their first 5 months of CSI high-speed, low-price internet service. For the real deal in high-speed at a low price, it's CSI Cable, your hometown internet professionals. Offer details at csicable.com.